In this practice, find the Fourier integrals of the following functions. Fx becomes 0 when the x is less than 0. Fx becomes 1 when the x is between the 0 and 2. Fx becomes 0, x is larger than 2. Fourier integrals of the fx is expressed 1 over pi 0 to the infinity a alpha cosine alpha x plus b alpha sine alpha x, and the integrals with respect to alpha. When the a alpha is calculated 0 to the 2, because fx becomes a 1 only the in this region, cosine alpha t dt. So you can perform this integrals, sine 2 alpha over alpha. Also you could calculate b alpha integral 0 to the 2 sine alpha t dt, because if x becomes a 1 between the 0 to the 2, so it becomes 1 over alpha, 1 minus cosine 2 alpha. So by substitute these equations a and b, then fx becomes 1 over pi 0 to the infinity sine 2 alpha over alpha cosine alpha x plus 1 over alpha 1 minus cosine 2 alpha sine alpha x d alpha. So this corresponds to the a alpha. This corresponds to the b alpha. Then sine 2 alpha is a double angle formula. It's 2 sine alpha cosine alpha. And this 2 sine square alpha. So it becomes 2 over pi 0 to the infinity sine alpha cosine alpha x minus 1. Using the addition formula for the trigonometric functions over alpha d alpha. So this is a Fourier integral of the fx. So if we substitute x equal 1 into the above equations, f1 is 1, so it becomes 1 equal 2 over pi 0 to the infinity, cosine 0 is 1, so sine alpha over alpha d alpha. So from this equation, we obtain the interesting integrals. If you integrate sine alpha and alpha d alpha, it becomes pi over 2. In this practice, I explained how to calculate the Fourier integrals. Okay, this is the end of this practice.